Tenenbaum and Schmidt continuum model. Tenenbaum and Schmidt concentrated more on delegation and freedom in decision making to subordinates and thereby on the team development. As a team's freedom increases, the manager's authority decreases. Now that's a good sign. This is a positive way for both teams and managers to get developed. Tenenbaum and Schmidt defined 7 levels of the delegated freedom, which moves from manager oriented on one side to subordinate oriented on the other side. So we are going to have a look at how does it look visually, and we'll see from this model what are the some of the things that we can acquire. So this is the Tenenbaum and Schmidt continuum model in the visual form. If you see, this is the manager oriented line, this is the subordinate oriented line, and this rectangle is divided into two kind of a parts. One is the area of freedom for subordinates and one is the use of authority by the manager, and this is a kind of a timeline. So you can imagine a new person coming in the team, then as time passes he grows in this fashion, in this direction. So the 7 levels, let's look at the first level. Here the first level says the manager takes decisions. So in this part, when the team member is here, the use of authority by the time manager, if you look at this graph, is very high, or the highest I would say. And here the area of freedom for the subordinate is the least. And here the manager takes all the decisions. As the time spent increases by the team member in the team, he comes at this point where obviously the area of freedom has increased and the use of authority has decreased from this to this. So it has shrinked from here to here, this level. Here the manager sells the decisions. So here the manager tries to give a reason for the decision to a certain extent, but still he is the one who is taking the decision entirely. The third level, manager presents decisions with ideas and invites questions. So as more time is spent by this person, as the manager presents decisions with certain ideas and invites questions, this particular team member, he sees himself now capable enough to ask some key questions, because he is now understanding what his role is and what his work responsibilities, so that he could have some of his own questions. Now as we go here, again we see that the freedom for the subordinate has increased and the authority for the manager has decreased. Now that continuum will continue, where the area of freedom keeps increasing as the time passes and the use of authority by the manager keeps decreasing as we go towards the end. So the fourth level, manager suggests provisional decisions and invites discussions. So here manager starts suggesting, having some ideas that he starts suggesting, and he invites discussion on that. Now this is where he is actually giving an opportunity to the team member that he can bring forth his reasoning. Now he is giving a respect in one way to the team member, that he is been given this opportunity to start giving any reasons, any way of handling that particular task on his own. So he starts inviting the discussion. So he has elevated him to a level where he is now much more capable in terms of his knowledge and skill, and maybe attitude also. The next level is the manager presents the situation and gets suggestion and then decides. So here at this level, which is the fifth level, he does not come that what I decide is what I am going to implement. He has this confidence in his team that if I am able to just present the situations, the team members themselves are now capable enough, they have built a muscle, they have their experience enough to actually suggest what could be the possible solutions, and then he thinks that he will decide the best solutions that would have come from the team members. The next level, that is the sixth level, is the manager explains, defines the parameters, and asks the teams to decide. Now here, he essentially just gives them certain parameters. As soon as the parameters are given, he does not even have to present the situation. The team member is now so much capable that they are able to immediately construct the situation within those parameters given by the boss, and then they are able to suggest any of the solutions and take a decision where the boss is playing a role just to facilitate taking the decisions. So essentially the team members are deciding on their own and not the boss. The last level for the manager is the manager allows team to develop options and decide on action within the manager's received limits. So in the last level, the managers allow almost entire thing, right from the understanding the parameters, the situation, taking a decision which is the best or the optimum solution for that particular problem, and allows them to decide, and the managers simply tells them within what limits this needs to be done. So the limits could be that this particular solution needs to be found within this timeline, or this needs to be found within these particular resources that are given, and the team member have to work upon themselves. In other words, when a team member joins as a fresh or a fresher, the manager's role is more about using his own authority and giving less of freedom. And as the person, as a team member grows in his knowledge, in his skills and his experience, the use of authority keeps decreasing and the area of freedom for the team member keeps increasing. And that's what it was seen and observed by Tenenbaum and Schmidt continuum model in a visual form. If you look at here, there had been levels of delegation that is happening that we need to see, right from where he takes entire decisions on his own to the next level where he starts slowly selling his decision, then slowly asking them to discuss, then slowly getting them to actually come out with solutions, and finally giving them the almost the entire parameters and just asking them to come up with the best solution. And he just gives them the limits in which he has to operate. That's about it. So this is also a continuum level, how the delegation is improved by the manager, how it develops the skills of delegation.